I'm Ben with Ben's Carts, and this is our newest creation.
This is one of the two steam tables that you have. Then you have a prep shelf that goes over to a sink with your hot and cold pressurized water system. Below the steam table here is your hot water heater, and this is the griddle shown. And then the other steam table, which is set up as a direct heat. You can change that any way you want. These are your coolers, and they have split top lids, insulated NSF. And one is 100 quart and the other is 70 quart. Opposite the serving window is your hand wash sink, and on either side is your fresh and wastewater storage containers. Now right here is your removable, detachable serving shelf. It's made of stainless, and then above it is your serving window with the marquee sign. Here's the top near the front of the trailer. Right above your cooking area is the vent and fan, and then down below is your 230-pound propane tanks. I want to do a little walk around with you on the outside. This is the rear, and that's the view inside. When the doors open, you'll see the commercial stainless latches, hinges, LED light bars, everything. Over here's your window. I'm going to explain this a little more here soon and show you how everything props up and how it sets up and the commercial hinges. This is a view inside to the stainless griddle that we put in. It's your choice, obviously, grill or griddle, and that's the griddle. Your serving shelf you can see there, and then you can also see your two double steam tables down below. Above here's your vent fan and one of the lights. There's two different lights. They'll work off the pigtail off your vehicle or your battery. We suggest getting a marine type battery to run all that. This is your marquee sign. It's the serving window that folds back on itself. It's got the braces, stainless and chrome fittings, gas pneumatic shocks for opening. And then it also has a bar to hold it in case of wind and or rain or whatever, or somebody pulls on it. Here's the bar being attached now.
It's got an indicator in it. When it's red, it's empty, and when you hook it to a new tank, and this switches it from side to side. When you switch it to a tank with gas in it, it turns green. So you know when you're out of gas, and then you just switch it over to the other tank.
Now here you notice the back door. Here's your LED lighting on the left and right of each door. Then at the top, you have your light bar. It's all trimmed. Spring catch for the door so the wind doesn't catch it. Now let's take a look inside real quick. On the left here is your prep area, your window serving area with your coolers. In the back is your two steam tables, right and left. They both come with steam pans, spillage pans. Here's your sink, and below those are your waste and fresh water. Down below the steam table, you can see the knobs for the hot water heater. This is your, it's all stainless steel, 304 NSF prep and wrap. And then here's a steam table with two quarter size and a perforated half size pan over water. Obviously, if you've watched my steam pan setups, you can see you can change that just by moving pans around. Over here is your other steam, full-size steam table, and above is your grill or griddle at your choice. I want to share some other stuff with you here real quick. This is a inside shot or inside view of the entire concession stand trailer or enclosed hot dog cart. The benefits is you're in the dry. Obviously, you know that. You've got a serving window that protects the customer standing under it from rain and wind and that kind of stuff. So on the left-hand side, you have two built-in coolers. Those two built-in coolers that I mentioned earlier, the 70 and the 100-quart coolers, are non-mechanical, which means, and if you've watched my free training videos, you know to use ice packs, gel packs, and not even use ice. I don't want to use ice because ice creates mess and it melts. And it's expensive. So we avoid that by using ice and gel packs, and that's what most professional vendors use. Now, over beyond that is your left side steam table. You can set it up any way you want. It comes with a full-size steam pan, three third-size inserts, pans, so that you can have water down below like a spillage pan, and then you could have products that don't need direct heat, but you want to keep them hot, and that's why it's over water. They're not holed. They're not perforated. They're just regular steam pans that go over a spillage pan. Now, you could change that out. You could remove the spillage pan in 2 seconds and have direct heat pans. So if you wanted to cook up something real fast, a batch of, you know, three different types of hot dogs, or if you wanted to switch out the pans for two half-size pans, you could do all that. I talk about that in my free training on the steam pans. Now, to the right of it, we've set that steam table, full-size steam table, up with a half-size pan perforated, which means it has holes in it, so that it catches steam for steaming foods or for steaming buns, whatever. And then on the left of it is two quarter-size pans inside that dome lid on the right is what I'm talking about, is your two quarter-size pans. So you could have your cheese sauce, chili sauce, whatever you're going to serve there. Above that is shown the griddle. The griddle has the grease trap. It's a commercial stainless, thick-plated, self-exhausting gas griddle. And it runs off the same gas lines that feed the hot water heater below it and the steam table. The hot water heater below it is like all the other steam tables we have. It has everything the same way as far as it's a on-demand, which means when you turn on the faucet, it turns on itself, it knows, and heats up the water so it delivers the water at the temperature you need. You can adjust that temperature however you want, but it'll meet all state codes and guidelines. The water lines below it, you can see the two to the right feed over to the sink. If you were to say, hey, we need more sinks, then your counter on the right-hand side, obviously you couldn't use it for anything but sinks, it would extend to the door. We leave it this way because most states will still require you have a commissary in order to store food. There's no way to store food for long periods of time here. Now, you could obviously get a bigger trailer. You could keep getting bigger till you could put, you know, 600 cubic foot freezers in them. But this is basically for those people that want a way to work year-round, staying out of the weather, and have the ability with most states to serve anything they want because they are an enclosed kitchen. So this will fit those needs without spending tens of thousands of dollars. And that was our goal with this cart. The walls are insulated, the roof's insulated, the floor. The floor has like a linoleum tile down that's easy to clean. It's rated by FDA Chapter 4 and meets those safety codes. The black line you see at the bottom of the hot water heater there is your gas line that feeds it. So you've got all your gas lines on that end near the tanks, which are on the outside of the trailer. Now, obviously, there's many things you can do with these. You can put in different types of shelf racking that you would like. You could add liquid dispenser pots. You could do all kinds of stuff, beverage machines. You could do whatever you wanted. You're limited on the space that you have. The goal here was for Ben's carts was to create a enclosed hot dog cart that had all the features that our best carts offer and then some. And it allows you to stay dry and serve in most states anything you want. So now you can do those cheeseburgers. You can do those steamed burgers like I show you how we do on the big dog cart. There's so many things you can do with this and make a lot of money. Our goal was to get all this done and give a quality trailer that didn't rock in the wind, didn't move around when you stepped inside of it, and do all of this at a reasonable price, something below the market average by a long shot. And we've done it. After watching this and you have any more questions, if you're on the Ben's Carts website, below this video is a full description, links to the drawings, everything you'll need. If you still have questions, please contact me, ben@benscarts.com, and I'll be happy to answer your questions. I appreciate you watching, and hope you have a fantastic day.